Theanesis.com. This is Knox. I'm Patchy, and we'll be doing cracking WPA this episode.
Alright, for this episode, we're going to show you how to crack WPA, WPA2 with the PSK, which is the pre-shared key. That's used in most home and small business network wireless networks they use. We're going to be using the WSB 54GC card, is what we recommended on the forums. We do have some problems with the drivers, but we do have the enhanced drivers online for you to download, which is going to allow you to do this attack. Basically, the attack consists of us doing the deauthentication to the network, which we showed you in episode 3, and then we're going to capture that four-way handshake, and then we're going to use a dictionary attack on that to get the passkey. And that's pretty much it.
Since we're using the Linksys W-USB54GC, we're going to have to update the drivers on Backtrack before we can go out war driving. There's a few steps to this process. The first thing we're going to do is remove the old drivers. To do that, we use modpro-r-rt73. And if you type in ifconfig-a, you'll see that the RA-USB0 interface is not displayed. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to download the enhanced drivers for our USB wireless device. As you can see, we are connected to the internet through our Ethernet interface. So you're going to have to do this before you go war driving. We're just going to open up Mozilla and do a simple Google search for the RT73 enhanced drivers. And just click on the first link, that's where I get it from. You scroll down, you'll find the Rawlink RT73 USB enhanced drivers. And if you look in the description, you'll see that capturing WPA handshakes is finally possible. Just scroll down a little further and download the newest drivers. This video, we're downloading the 2.0.1 drivers. The drivers are going to be compressed in a tar.bz2 format. So we're just going to do the command tar-xf and then the file name, and that will decompress it. After you decompress it, you'll see the folder with the same name. Just navigate to it, and inside that folder there will be a module folder, and navigate to that one. Then you're going to type the command make, which will compile the drivers. This will take a few seconds. Once it's done, type in make install, and this will install the drivers. Alright, to check that the drivers were properly installed, type in mod info RT73 and scroll up, look at the description. And as you can see, it was installed. What you want to do now is physically unplug your USB device and plug it back in, and then it'll be recognized by Backtrack 2 with updated drivers.
Alright, now let's go crack some WPA.
Alright, here we are, we're driving around, got Kismet running, and looking for some networks encrypted with WPA. Patches Wi-Fi, let's crack that shit. Alright, the first thing we're going to do is enable our wireless card and put it into monitor mode. Our command's going to be a little bit different this time. We're going to change the transfer rate to one megabyte. It makes packet injection a little bit more reliable. You can see here it's in monitor mode and the bitrate is 1 megabyte. Then we do IWPRIV, our interface, Force Prism 1. This will fix the power problem that you have in AeroDump. A lot of times it'll say like -1. This will correct that error. Then we do IWPRIV again, the interface, RFMON TX. This will allow us to do better packet injection. Then we're just going to run up AeroDump to get to figure out which channel our targeted wireless network is on. And as you can see, it is on channel 6. And it is indeed encrypted with WPA. AeroDump also shows you that it uses the pre-shared key instead of the radius server, so we can crack it. Next thing we want to do is do the iwconfig again and make sure our interface is only capturing data from channel 6. And then we want to do the deauthentication. That's AeroPlay-0, 5, because it's going to do it 5 times, because sometimes it doesn't deauthenticate right away. Then dash A, and then the BSSID, which is the access points MAC address, then our interface. We've explained this all before in episode 3. And before we run that, we want to open another AeroDump to make sure we capture the four-way handshake. This time we're going to run AeroDump on this specific channel and write it to a dump file. Write all the packets to a dump file. Alright. And now we're just going to run our deauthentication attack. You may have to run the deauthentication attack a couple times because your wireless card has to capture all four of the handshakes to be able to crack it. And if you look in the AeroDump at the bottom, it'll show you that there is indeed a client connected to Apache's Wi-Fi, so you're not just continually doing the deauthentication for no reason. I mean, there actually is a user reconnecting. Your wireless card isn't capturing all four of those packets. So just run it a few times. Hopefully you'll get it. And AeroDump will notify you in the upper right corner that you captured all four of the handshakes, as you can see right there. We're going to run a dictionary attack because it's very unlikely to be able to brute force one of these passwords because it takes a lot longer than cracking a normal password hash. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the dictionary that comes with Backtrack 2. It's stored in the directory pentest password dictionaries, and its file name is wordlist.txt.zip or .z. We're going to use gunzip to unzip it. Basically the command gunzipped and then the file name. After you run it, it'll show up in the directory as unzipped, and then you can use it with aircrack. We just type in aircrack, our dump file, dash w, and then the location of the word list, which is pentest, password, dictionaries, wordlist.txt. And then you have to select the network that you want to run this attack on, and after that it'll run the attack. This does take a while because it is kind of slow. It only does about 100 keys a second, so it will take a while, and this dictionary is quite large, so we'll time lapse this for you so you don't have to sit here and watch it. Alright, there you go. It found the key. It's infinity. That's all you have to do to crack WPA.
Well, that's it of this episode of Full Disclosure from InfinityExists.com. On a cracking WPA, I am Knox, and that is Patch, and you guys take it easy.